about this? Where does the water on the outside of a water bottle or on your bathroom mirror or maybe outside on the lawn or even on your car, where does that water come from? Remember that there's three states of matter: solid, liquid, and gas. When we think of water as a solid, we're thinking of ice. When we think of water as a liquid, we're thinking of water, and that sounds kind of unusual. Liquid, water. When water's in a gaseous state, we call it water vapor. What I'd like you to do is pause the video at this point, take out your notebook, and copy this chart down in detail. Take as much time as you need. Make sure you've got everything on there. All right, now let's take a minute to go over this. We've got water as a solid, ice, water as a liquid, water, water as a gas, water vapor. Whenever I heat it, whenever I add heat to water, if it's a solid, it's going to melt and become a liquid. When I add more heat to it, it evaporates and becomes a gas, water vapor. When I have water vapor and I cool it, it's going to condense and become liquid water. If I cool that liquid water further, it's going to freeze and return to its solid state as ice. Did the water on the outside of the water bottle come from inside or the outside? Was the water bottle leaking? Was it dripping? Was the water inside somehow evaporating and getting out of the bottle? Think about that for a moment. Here's the explanation. Over here, I've got a model of a water molecule. One oxygen atom, two hydrogen atoms. It looks like a little Mickey Mouse. The chemical symbol for water is H2O. That's where that comes from. Two hydrogen atoms, H2, one oxygen atom, O. It looks like a little Mickey Mouse. Now, there's water vapor in the air. You can take out a mirror, you can take out a cup, breathe on it, you're going to fog it. That's water vapor that's in your breath. There's water vapor floating around out here in the air around us. These little water molecules are just bouncing around having a good time. But when they touch the cold surface of the outside of the water bottle, that water vapor cools, condenses, and turns into a liquid dripping down the outside of the bottle. The water on the outside of the water bottle, the water on your mirror, the water on the lawn, the water on the car, did not come from inside the cup. It came from water vapor out in the air. That water vapor condensed into liquid when it touched the cold outside surface of the cup. If you have any questions or you need to understand something a little bit more, you can always get me at BORDUATE@collierschools.com.